Hello, dear students. Today here I am. As some of students asked me to make videos for the better understanding, as they can repeat or revise bones by watching the videos. So here I am with my video, and as we have started by introduction of upper limb. Now today we will see the first bone as the inauguration of upper limb. So the clavicle is also called as the collarbone. Here it is a clavicle, it is in my hand. So students, as previously we have discussed, every bone has its characteristics or special, what we can say, the bony impressions. And if you understand it very well, then you will be able to decide the to see the muscle attachments, and for it is very essential for the dissection also. So initially, see the how it lies in our body. Okay, so this is the clavicle, and the anatomical position of clavicle is like that. Exactly what I hold in the way, the anterior surface of medial two-third should direct forward and downward. Okay, so medial two-third of the shaft has anterior surface, and it should direct forward and downward. Okay, so what is the introduction of clavicle? It is a collarbone. It lies in the it connects the arm or shoulder with the axis and sternum, so that arm can swing clearly away from the body. Okay, this is the possible because of clavicle, and also it transmit the weight of upper limb on the sternum or the axis. Okay, so this is the role of clavicle in our body. Then the side determination of clavicle. So how to decide the side of clavicle, whether it belongs to right side or left side. Okay, so see what it has. We have to see randomly what the parts of clavicle. It has medial end, it has lateral end, and the shaft. Okay, the shaft has curvatures. So the lateral end is flattened from above downwards. This is the lateral end, which is flattened from above downwards, and this is the medial end, which is quadrangular and quite large as compared with the lateral end. Okay, so as this is the medial end, it is directed medially. This is the lateral end, it should be on lateral side. Okay, now if I hold bone like this way, again you will say this is the medial end and this is the lateral end. Then what is the difference? Now see, the medial end is quadrangular, which is directed medially. Lateral end is flattened from above downward. Okay, now the shaft is divided into medial two-third and lateral one-third. Medial two-third of shaft is convex forward. Medial two-third of the shaft is convex forward, while lateral one-third portion is concave forwards. It is concave forwards. Okay, now see, again if I hold the bone like this way, again medial end is medially, lateral end is on lateral side, anterior two-third medial two-third of shaft is convex forward, and lateral one-third is concave forward. Now again you will say how to decide the side. Now see students, the inferior surface of the medial two-third has subclavian groove, and the lateral one-third inferior surface has this trapezoid ridge and conoid tubercle. Conoid tubercle, this is the tubercle like structure. So this is the conoid tubercle, and this one is the slightly blue color is given. So that is the trapezoid ridge. Okay. So, how you will decide the side? Medial end is quadrangular, lateral end is flattened, medial 2/3 of the shaft is convex forward, lateral 1/3 of the shaft is concave forward, while the inferior surface of medial 2/3 has subclavian groove and inferior surface of lateral 1/3 has conoid, tubercle and trapezoid ridge. See student, it is very important to observe bone clearly. We all know due to pandemic it is very it has become very difficult to interact with you and to show the bones clearly, but how it is possible, I am doing that. See, medial end is quadrangular, you can see it is quite large, lateral end is flattened from above downward, and inferior surface, see, this is the subclavian groove, okay, and this is the conoid, tubercle and trapezoid ridge, okay, and this decides the side of the bone. So this clavicle belongs to right side, obviously, because if I hold the bone like this way, the inferior surface is coming superiorly and it is not correct, okay, get it? Okay, now see the structure of clavicle. The clavicle has four parts: the medial end, lateral end and shaft, the medial 2/3 of shaft and lateral 1/3 of the shaft. Before to see the structure, we will see the characteristics of clavicle, the peculiarities of clavicle, as it is a special bone. Why it becomes special? Because it is the only long bone which lies horizontally in our body, which lies horizontally, okay. Remaining all long bones lies vertically. For example, humerus, radius, ulna, okay. So clavicle lies horizontally in our body. Then second, it has no medullary cavity. What is medullary cavity? Medulla, which stores the bone marrow, red and yellow. So it is also called as the marrow cavity. So it has no marrow cavity, okay. And it is the first bone to ossify. Ossification. And is of ossification is membranous. It is of two types: cartilaginous ossification and membranous ossification. So the clavicle has membranous ossification. It is the first bone to ossify, and it has no medullary cavity, and it is the only long bone which lies horizontally. Again, if we press here, we can feel the bone. That is, it is subcutaneous throughout. Okay, subcutaneous means it just lies below the skin, so we can feel on our body. So this is the subcutaneous bone throughout. So these are the some peculiarities of clavicle, and after that, gross anatomy means the structure of the clavicle. And what is the role of clavicle? We have seen previously that it transmit the weight of upper limb on the axis of sternum. Again, medially, the medial end is also called as the sternal end, which is quadrangular and which get articulate with the sternum. Which part of sternum? The clavicular notch of the manubrium sterni to form the sternoclavicular joint. Okay, this medial end, it has articular facet here. See, this is the articular facet which get articulate with the clavicular notch of the manubrium sterni, and this joint is sternoclavicular joint. As well, lateral end is also called as the acromial end, and see, on its lateral part it has a facet, okay, some part is it get destroyed, so cannot see it properly. So this is the lateral end along with facet. This facet articulate with the acromion process of scapula to form the acromioclavicular joint. So medial end forms sternoclavicular joint, lateral end forms the acromioclavicular joint. Okay, these two joints and ligaments are there, coracoclavicular ligament, sternoclavicular ligament. Okay, so in next lecture we will see the attachments of clavicle. Before that, the gross anatomy, see four parts. The clavicle has medial end, lateral end and shaft. Shaft is divided into medial 2/3, which is convex forward, and lateral 1/3, which is concave forwards. Again, I repeat, see, medial end is quadrangular. It is also called as sternal end. It get articulate with the clavicular notch of manubrium sterni to form the sternoclavicular joint. Then the lateral end is called as acromial end. It has facet which get articulate with the acromion process of scapula to form the acromioclavicular joint. Okay, now the shaft. Shaft is divided into medial 2/3, lateral 1/3. Medial 2/3, which is the convex forwards, it has four surfaces. It has four surfaces. How many surfaces? Four surfaces. Now see, I try to show you the surfaces clearly. See, this is the anterior surface. This is the anterior surface, which is directed forward and quite downward. Okay, so it is the anterior surface, which is quite rough as compared with the posterior surface. Now see, the posterior surface, this is the posterior surface, which is smooth as compared with the anterior surface. The posterior surface, which is smooth, anterior surface, which is quite rough. The superior surface, this is the superior surface. Superior surface, in its medial part, it is rough. Otherwise, it is smooth. And the inferior surface, again, in its medial part, it has oval impression, and its lateral part, it has subclavian groove. So see, this is the anterior surface. Now see, posterior surface. Okay, this is the posterior surface. Now the superior surface, this is the superior surface, and the inferior surface. See, this is the subclavian groove and this is the oval impression. Okay, so these are the four surfaces, and the provision to describe the four surfaces we will see in the next video, the attachment of clavicle. Now the lateral 1/3, again it has, as it is flattened from above downward, so it has anterior border. See, this is the anterior border, which is concave forwards, and posterior border, this is the posterior border, which is convex backwards. Okay, see here, I have marked this. This is the anterior border, which is concave forward, and this is the posterior border, which is convex backward. Now the surface, this is the superior surface, it is quite rough, and the inferior surface, this is the inferior surface, which is having conoid, tubercle and trapezoid ridge for the attachment of coracoclavicular ligament. Okay, so this is the conoid tubercle and this is the trapezoid ridge, inferior surface of lateral 1/3. So this is all about the structure of clavicle. Okay, so you just go through the your textbook and read once again the bone, and tomorrow and the next video we will see the muscle attachment. Okay, and for your convenience, I have made this video. So share it, like it, and if feasible, to ask to your all friends to subscribe the channel as well as to like the video. Thank you.